Luciano Berio's Jesse was commissioned by the Dutch flutist Frans Bruggen. And when Berio and Bruggen met the first time to talk about the instrument and the piece, Berio wanted to know what is the most difficult thing in recorder playing. And Bruggen thought about it, then he said, it's the coordination between the movement of the fingers and the articulation of the tongue. So what Berio did, he completely disconnects these two elements, and for the first two pages of the piece, I can show you the score, it's quite graphic, tongue, articulation, movement of the fingers are completely disconnected, and then gradually they come together, and only in the end of the piece you can hear a, for our ears, normal melody, where tongue and fingers work together. And Berio also wrote in the letter with the manuscript, you are responsible for one of the strangest gestures of my life. I'm celebrating the divorce between your fingers and your tongue. The other thing Berio wanted to know is what is the most beautiful note and the ugliest note on your instrument? Bruggen had a very special instrument, which I don't own, a tenor with the key, and on this instrument, this was the ugliest note. And Bruggen thought the most beautiful sound was this. Maybe you keep these two notes, I'll play them again, in mind, they might come back in the piece. And then there's one last thing which plays into the music. Berio liked to write pieces which really fit the performer and also sometimes make jokes about the performers. And Bruggen was Dutch, so in the Dutch language the sound is very dominant, so this might come through in the piece. And the other thing is, Bruggen smoked a lot, so he might have had a smoker's cup.
Mm-hmm. Of my safety and those on the front row, I'm going to play tonight seated. I do hope you will enjoy.
Thank you. flute and piano by the Swiss composer Frank Martin, who this year, 2024, is actually the 50th anniversary of his passing away, so there might be more of his name around this year. That piece was written in 1939 for the Geneva competition, and I love playing it because it brings out unique characters of the flute. We're normally portraying birds or pretty melodies, and that piece is more about the dark side and chromaticism, and he was strongly influenced by Schoenberg's serialism 12-tone harmonic system as well. The next piece we'll play, the final piece, is the fantasy on Weber's Der Freischütz by Paul Taffanel, which you might have guessed is a fusion of French and German musical styles, and it is a wonderful piece to play because we get all the lovely tunes that the singers normally get, and it's arranged so well by Paul Taffanel, who was professor of flutes at the Paris Conservatoire, also around the same time as Frank Martin was working.
Thank you.